What's going on, world? I'm your host, George Kill, and welcome to the sixth and final episode of Sneak Peek Season 5, also known as our season of First Reloaded. Dating all the way back to February of this year, we've kept consistent with our season of first theme by spotlighting the first woman in Allison Felix, the first skateboarder in Paul Rodriguez, the first episode filmed in the storage courtesy of Wilson Chandler, and many, many others. So in the last of season 5, we put the spotlight on the first military person, Jaaziel Ramos, a Fort Lewis, Washington-based soldier who is also a part of the tribe called Fresh. Shout out to John Reaper. Check out his insane Air Jordan 4 collection and other sneakers he holds dear to his heart. All right, Night 6 fam, we're out here at the Fort Lewis military base with my man Jazz. What's going on, man?
What's up, man?
Good to see you.
Finally, man. Finally good to see you.
Right. You know you're the first military person we've featured in the series.
Man, that puts a lot of pressure on me.
This tank is putting a lot of pressure on me. So let's get inside and check what you got going on in there.
We should do that. Cool. Well, since I knew you guys was coming, I actually set up something for you guys, something special, dear to my heart. You know, the Air Jordan 4 is something that's, since day one, since I first started collecting, I fell in love with, you know, since 1999 Breds. That was the first shoe I actually fell in love with back in middle school. That's the first shoe I started learning about. And then I actually got it in 2010. That was my first 1999 Jordan. When I got this shoe, I was living a rough time. It was a rough time, you know, and I actually sold most of my collection. And this was one shoe I could not get rid of. But you can see, this took a beating in high school. This is how I played soccer. Basketball, this shoe has taken a beating, so I actually had to get another pair because this pair is obviously, it's about to die on me. Right here is actually roughly, I think, 46 to 50 pairs, and they're actually all retired, so I don't actually wear them no more since I actually completed a set from 1989 till current, minus quais and a few samples that I'm still, you know, trying to acquire. Other than that, they just gonna stay as a collection piece. And once I get a home, you know, they'll be displayed correctly. These are actually the Sunset Force. So they released for a high school in Portland, and it was an actual baseball team. So if you look at the actual shoe, you can see the clay in the actual mesh. And they were actually played in, and you know, eventually they'll be street legal and swapped. So hopefully that comes around soon. I had a friend in Portland that actually, he had two pairs. And he actually blessed me one of his pairs and passed it down because he knows I'm an actual Ford collector and he knows I appreciate it. So this pair is an actual Mosh custom. And like the Eminem 2s, it has Biggie Smalls lyrics all around the shoe. It's supposed to represent his life and his death. I got it from a store in Florida. I think it was Soul Society. So shout out to them for hooking me up with this pair.
Which four is your most recent pickup?
My most recent is actually the two-tone sample. So from what I know, this shoe is like a unicorn, not too many pairs of these. And it's just everything, the tumbled leather, even the yellowing on the mesh, it just shows character. Like, I love that yellowing. I actually wore it once and it started chipping on me, so these have just been retired as well, just collection purposes. I went to Portland just to pick up these. These are actually my size, which is incredibly hard to find because, as you know, all the football players do not wear size 9 and below. And I'm actually size 9 and below. So this actually is, from what I know, it's two pairs in this size. And I was blessed with this pair. One of my favorite fours out of my collection.
Tell me, what's the significance of you having multiple pairs of white laser fours?
Okay, so, like I said, with the black lasers, I used to wear those a lot, and I got the white lasers in high school as well. And the actual pair that I had in high school, I traded it off, and I got a DS pair for that pair. So then after that, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna start doubling up on those because it's just a beautiful shoe, you know? Just that lasering on the sneaker from the black and the red, you know? Like, this is not, it can't be duplicated, you know? And it's a unique shoe, it's one of a kind. So I plan on getting 10 pairs each. When I first started learning about sneakers, I started reading about the OGs and learning about OG sneakers and the history behind them. And the 4, like I said, was the first shoe that I started to learn. And I fell in love with the sneaker. So I just felt that I had to buy it. So even this pair cracking and falling apart, it just tells a story, you know? it's a historical piece, you know. And this pair is, you know, it's talking, but it's still fully intact. Like out of the 89 set, my favorite pair has to be the Fire Red. This is, I would say, one of the cleanest pairs I've ever seen of a 1989 Fire 4. Like, it's still intact. The leather is just beautifully, no cracking, no chipping. Still with that Nike Air inside. This shoe is in better condition than some of the pairs that come out nowadays, you know? My top has to be the History of Flight 4. We can't let these go, you know? I've actually worn these. Shout out to Soul Protector, because these are, you know, I've worn these a couple times. This will probably be number two. Number one will be the 1999 Bread. Then number three, I would say the Columbias, because this shoe is just beautiful. That midsole, I'm actually real happy that they're gonna retro. That way I can actually wear them, you know? So that'll be number three. Number four, which is a very slept on shoe, would be the Mist Blue 4. You don't actually see these too much anymore. So this will be number four. I actually love this colorway. The yellow just sets it off. And then number five will be the Lightning.
You have a nice collection so far, definitely. Where do you find time to wear these shoes when you have to wear boots most of the time?
So, since I'm in the military, it's actually, I don't really wear my shoes because, you know, working from, let's say, PT hours, 6 o'clock in the morning till 5, you know, then I go to the gym. So I really don't wear, I usually just use it for collection purposes. But with retros now, I usually stash them anyways and I'll bring them out later on, maybe a few years from now, that way they'll still be crisp and everybody's, you know, already beat their pairs up.
Is it harder for you to find shoes with you being in the military?
To be honest, I would say the hardest part about buying shoes would be getting the retros nowadays, because no matter if I'm in the military or not, with raffles and campouts, it's still almost impossible with the bots. I've had almost the full set of History of Flight, so right here we have the twos, the threes, the sixes, the 16s, and then got the 15s. This is one of the most underrated History of Flight there is, to be honest with you. Got the 17s. Another underrated sneaker. This whole collection was just executed. You don't understand the materials, the sock liner. Look at that inside, just, it's insane. Then the 18s. Another crazy shoe. Then the 19s. Then we got the 22s. Oh. This is another slept on shoe. Very underrated. The History of Flight colorway is just on every shoe History of Flight colorway is amazing. My favorite out of the whole set of History of Flight would have to be the threes. The threes are beautiful. I've been offered crazy amounts of money. And I actually got offered a bulk deal to include these, the Oregon 5, and History of Flight 6. And I couldn't do it. I just emotionally attached to them. I couldn't do it.
One thing I'm noticing about your collection is you like to collect series.
Yes.
You have the whole 4 series. You have the majority of the History of Flight series. You're the first person that has the City series that we've seen on Sneak Peek.
When I collect something, the way I like to do it is to finish a set, because I don't like to have bits and pieces. So I first got the Shadow 10s, and then I just got the Steels, and now I figured might as well try and get them on, which was, it was very hard because I only collect in my size. You know, I know people that, you know, they go out of their size range. I buy only in my size, whether it's an OG, a sample, only in my size. So all these I can wear. I mean, since I live in Seattle, I actually did a photo shoot with those, and we did the Space Needle in the background, and it was a pretty crazy picture.
So what's the next series you're trying to collect?
The next, I'm trying to finish the 8s. So I have the 6s done. infrareds, the carmines. This was actually my last six that I picked up, which, man, this to find in this condition is almost impossible. Like, I would say you could probably wear this because there is no cracking nowhere on this shoe, but I wouldn't do it, because then I'll end up looking like my sport blue, and then I'll be upset when that happens. So I actually got two pairs of the sport blue six, the infrared with that 3M. It's still icy, 1991. I got the 7 set. This pair right here is a 1990 Fire 5, which it's to find completely intact, you know. Same. I got the 1990 metallic, but then I got the 1999. So you guys can see the differences. So you can see the cut on the shoe itself. This one's lower. The meshing, it's a little different. The teeth, you see how it's pointy? These are rounded teeth. And then the insoles, black on the 1999, red on the 1990. Yellowing character on all shoes. Yeah. No matter what shoe it is, yellow adds character. This is the Silver Tongue 1990, which this one's kind of falling apart on me. So I've seen on Sneak Peek, a lot of people don't show nines enough, especially OGs. So I thought I'd bring out the OG Olive Nines, which is better than the actual retro pair. So you can see, like, on the retro, it's a little more greener, and this is it's gotten brown after time. So here's the OG Olive Nine. Then I got the OG Playoffs, or True Reds, as the OG name is called. So as you can see, that sparkle, the OGs, man. Everything they did with the shoe is just incredible. Here we got the Rainbow 2009s. So they actually released these 1 through 23, then 2009, 2010. And each shoe, 1, 2, 3, and 4, each pair was a different color of the spectrum. And this is actually the only pair that I have kept so far. So I had the 7s and 8s, which is a crazy, it's like a banana color, insane. And then the sock liner on each shoe is white like this. So kind of like the History of Flights, but in white color. Then I have another shoe that I thought myself I would never own. So I had a pair before, which was the release pair. This is the actual promo sample pair of the M&M 2s. So the only differences that I've seen when I had both pairs, when I compared, I guess it has a little more writing on it. But other than that, you can see on the inside, the promo sample tag. But the funny part about this story, when they released, I don't remember the year, I think it was 2008. I was in high school, right? And I told my mom, I was like, Ma, I need to get these shoes. And retail was, I think, $139, something like that. I can't remember exactly. And she took me to my mom's friend's house to use her computer, because we didn't have a computer at the time. And I'm on there camping on the computer, and I put the shoe in my cart, right? I start putting the credit card information, and when it happened, the computer crashes on me. It just turned off, and I started crying. I was like, Ma, the computer. Right. And after that, there was no way I could find out my size. So I know I've been showing you a lot of OGs, and I thought I'd change it up a little bit. So I thought I'd come to over here. This is where I keep a lot of my OG sneakers, and I collect, so like I said, I collect in sets, which this set is not done yet. So here's the Air More Much Tempo. So as you can see from this shoe, compared to the OG Tempo, it's completely different from the Air, the midsole on the back. As you can see, it one says Nike, one has a swoosh. So those are two differences from the Much and the Tempo itself, the Air More. This one I actually picked up while I was deployed. When I was in Afghanistan, we'd be on missions for 2 weeks at a time. And when we came back, I used to go on eBay, because that was like my sanctuary, you know, like that's what I would take the stress off my mind when I was deployed, looking at shoes, you know. And this sneaker popped up, and I've been wanting this shoe ever since I was in high school. Like, this shoe was on my grail list since then. And I saw it pop up, and I told my friend they were up for $700. I told my friend, yo, should I buy them? He was like, man, that's a lot of money for that shoe. And I was like, man, I don't know. Like, I was going back and forth, and I just couldn't let them go. And now they're going for like two racks. Out of all shoes, all time, this is on the top 5. Then we got the white and red colorway. This is another, it's kind of hard to find nowadays because usually they pop up in only big sizes. So this shoe, actually, somebody on Instagram, I posted saying I was looking for them. He told me he'll sell to me for 90 bucks. And I was like, yo, let's do it. Like, that's a steal. So hopefully I keep finding shoes like that, you know? I'm trying to finish this set eventually. I had three pairs of shoes from middle school to I got to 10th grade. I was rocking some Air Force Ones. They was leaning to the side. I had some Reeboks that were all messed up. And then I finally picked up my first Jordan, which was actual 2006 Fire 5. I was a freshman in 2006, and this shoe was set to retro. And I actually begged her to buy me these shoes. My sister's boyfriend at the time, he worked at Nike, Nike factory in Orlando. And he actually hooked me up with these. They surprised me for Christmas. And I started bawling. And ever since that just fueled the fire, you know? It just made me fall in love with the sneaker. Just everything about shoes, you know? Like, some people collect different things and they find peace in it, you know what I'm saying? Like, whenever I'm with people that collect shoes or at events, it's just, I'm in a peaceful state with myself, you know? No stress.
I'd like to thank you, Jazz, for letting me come out and check out another sneak peek episode, man. You have an amazing four collection. Those up tempos are crazy. Thank you, man.
I appreciate it, man. Hope to see you guys again.